opportunities for Raze. Oh, actually, he's going to get in there, but he's just going to turn this one around. Emperor's Divide onto Edge. As now Stands United comes in, but he still connects to Stretch Armstrong. Does Raze score turning up? Does get the Arctic Assault as in goes Smeb. No hookshot to actually land and find the target.
No first spot in the game just yet.
Yeah, an interesting first buy from Smeb as well as... Oh my god, okay!
Right. He uses the soldiers and doesn't have something to escape to, there's a chance.
Yeah, good positioning from Raze to make sure that he's still in Fog of War.
I used the soldier, I used both of them this time.
Yep, score is right here though as the Kidnap does bring him back. Yukal throws out the Emperor's Divide and shifts some sand to get himself out.
Second item is a long way away, Atlas. So
oh yeah.
There's going to be a lot of power in the Ezreal. And they're actually just going to have Ezreal go bot lane. And it's going to feel like a mid lane Ezreal because he's just going to zone people away from the minion.
And a fantastic forward ward here by Smeb as well. He's not taken any of this little funny business that Secret's trying to bring into the top lane. It feels like this season's Kuro.
The ward was just about to time out, so that was just the final announcement of, yep.
Yeah, we thought that Edge might be decent competition. He has had a good performance as Deft and Mata. To try and run away from Edge, which is strange. The flash actually comes
it's
in.
Nice.
Stands United down as well as Edge turns up. They've got the Devourer onto Deft, and the flash comes out from Mata. Somehow they're still alive as the rest of KT finally turn up. It's Deft who's going to be the first one to die, but the Kidnap is going to be the own Deft of the Zac. Smeb picks up two already. Roach is going to go down. Make that a third potentially. Yes, it is.
They want more.
Triple kill comes in. The flash. Smeb could go for a quadro kill. And this could actually be his 1,000th kill in a quadro. No, Yukal is going to deny that one. Edge on the wrong side of this battle. Yukal comes in. He wants to find some more. Smeb, he wants 1,000 kills on this
one.
He gets it. That's going to be the ace at the beginning of the game as KT only lose Deft.
1,000 kills, first top lane to get. The crowd get the confirmation. Congratulations to Smeb. He's been right up there, top three top laner since 2015.
You mentioned aborted scrim. It feels exactly like that.
We get the replay, and this was almost the greatest escape we've ever seen. How many bad guys to take down our protagonist, Deft and Mata, who had walked away with the lane. Yes, it was four. They eventually, it's five, sorry. They needed the Shen also to join them. Unfortunately, everything was down, and then Smeb and KT are feeling it. As true a 4v5 as you could ever call, they rush in, and there's no exit plan for the side of Kongnu Monster.
Yeah, just beautifully executed by Smeb as well. He was a one-man wrecking ball. Yukal did his bit on the back end. It's just KT styling at this stage. Nothing Edge can do.
Always difficult to talk about these games. You never want to mince words, but you kind of need...
The youngster going to take down the Baron.
Now, Kongnu Monster don't know for sure, but they can't do anything. It's going to be free. Other side of KT.
This is the KT that we wanted to see this series. I know it's not the Kongnu Monster, it's now. The catch is actually going to be on to Yukal. Does get the Emperor's Divide down in the end. It does so much damage. Is KT looking to try and turn up? Raze does get at least the Stretch Armstrong, but Deft in the backline, untouched. Featherstorm, is it going to be able to do anything? I'm not entirely sure. Deft, Arcane shifting forward. Secret just wandered out of. You mentioned Deft being unable to move out of that one earlier on. Smeb continues split pushing. And despite the fact that they do give Yukal his first death so far of the LCK, not going to be able to find too much more after that as Raze jumps in and will just straight up die.
4v5, no, they keep going forward,
either.
But now it might actually be 4v4.
Yep, in goes Smeb, make it 1,001 as Sol's going to get destroyed. Roach trying to get out. Weaver's Wall does absolutely nothing. Base is now broken in two places. Top inhibitor will go down. And they really have to kill Deft if they want to save any of these structures because he just does so much damage, not to mention Smeb as well. And they're actually going for the end. We've got a minute left on this Baron buff. As Secret and Roach, I don't think they're going to be enough. They just can't kill minions. And these Nexus turrets are getting destroyed 26 minutes into the game. And KT Rolster, we haven't seen a shellacking like this for a very long time. And damn, they look good doing it. What is that, Smeb? So much damage. Raze is going to respawn, but the Nexus, that ain't going to until game number two. and KT Rolster. Yes, they changed up their mid lane, but I think we're going to need another showing to be able to make any real assessments.
Yeah, KT Rolster just blow away Kongnu Monster. Not a game after the early laning phase where Zaya Rakan just died straight up 2v2 to a big lick coming through from Mata.
Yeah.
Yukal on his first game showed great mechanics. Again, like you say, we'll need more tape to really get a full information. Sadly for Kongnu Monster, we get all the tape we need to know that this struggle will extend. It'll be very difficult for them as the other 9 teams have moved forward to actually match them. There's 2 match wins in the first 4. Might be sparing them some blushes because 7 losses in a row seems right around the corner.
Yeah, it's one of those games where if you imagine it like it was 2 armies facing off like in Braveheart or something like that, what KT did was pretty much drop a nuke on the other side, and then there's no real need for any of these sort of fights because the early game dictated that Kongnu had absolutely nothing that they could do, but hopefully they can get their spirits back in order because after a game like that, it was over very, very quickly. Just don't dwell on it. Try and rejig your mind to maybe grab a different draft, cancel things out for KT, limit some of their options, and come back fighting in game number 2.